Don't y'all sometimes feel like Cardi B up in the place? Oh dear, dear, dear. I knew this was gonna happen, but you know, it's mad. And then you got people who would comment and say that she did a WAP song and she was bragging about it and how obviously she kind of deserved it because she knew what she was getting herself into. But bitch, I know people have been in a relationship where you feel as if because they're cheating and stuff like that, they do it to people that they class as someone that they can easily do that to. And then after they will portray themselves as like they are really genuinely a nice guy. They will come to a female and hunt them down for the longest time to make it seem as if that is the case. Like you're literally ready to settle down with that one person, and that has never been the case. That was never your intention. You just wanted to get a better whap. But then again, it is sad because it's like there is a lot of guys out there nowadays. They will go to the full extent of being in a long relationship with you, getting married with you, wanting to spend time with you, wanted to sex you, like wanted to even have a child of you. And that's the thing that pisses me off, is when they actually want to have a child with you, they're the one that's literally put it and laid it out on the table and said they've wanted a child with you. And then as soon as obviously you basically get your wish, it's like they turn their back from that situation. They're like, okay, in their mind it's like, okay, we've got them. So do you know what, I know for a fact that if I ever wanted to, I can easily get back to her. If I really wanted to manipulate her mind, I can easily manipulate her mind. And then afterwards, because we're there thinking to ourselves, do you know what? Every man kind of like cheats at some point or does something, or maybe it's something that I was doing wrong to why I always see that it was a situation or why he cheated, or, you know, like there is so many different reasons to why us females still go there, assuming that this is the perfect one or the perfect guy. Like even you will have your friends or some family members who will go to you and be like, oh rah, like I don't like this guy, there's something about him, but he seems like he's a cheat, or he seems like this, or whatever the situation may be. And that is them actually just saying that because of something they saw on a social media platform, or just a simple fact that they're jealous, or it could be for many different reasons as well again. But then it's like, because you're the one that's in that relationship, you're the one that's in that shoe, it's like it's a bit hard to just kind of like, oh yeah, my friend's right, yeah, okay, go fuck you, like we know we're breaking up now for life. Like it's a bit hard to do that. Don't watch a spotty face, by the way, people, because you know, it's that time, it's that season. This season, I just seem to get spotty for some unknown reason. And it's meant to be summer, you're supposed to get spotty now because it's like your face is sweating and then you got a makeup that's rubbing against your face and your skin. But hey, everybody's different, right? But yeah, I just thought I'd just point that out there because like there's a lot of people who would quickly jump. This boy is driving me crazy. Are you okay? Like, are you feeling okay? Are you feeling okay? Eyes. Yeah, and when you get caught slipping, you try to act like, what? Why is she recording me for? No. You finished, Shai? Too funny. But yeah, so I just wanted to like kind of say that because obviously I see the situation and everything like that. It's a good time to kind of like get back into doing media. It's kind of good to just like get back into videos and stuff like that. So I thought this would be the like the best opportunity to do so, seeing as like, yeah, there's a lot that's happened and stuff like that. Obviously everyone knows and everyone's gone through like their situation and stuff like that. I'm the type of person, I go silent and isolate myself for like for weeks on ends, yeah, until I've actually passed one of my goals that I wanted to do or achieve in the first place. Until I've achieved that, then I can go around bragging and I can go around doing videos and I can go around boasting and I can tell you the guys at the level that I'm at, because I feel happy within myself at the level that I'm actually at. So that's how it is, really, literally. But I do need to do more videos in order to build, promote myself, I guess, and build like something. Something, but so a catch up with the situation. We have people who are still going on with their fuckery, treating women how they want to be treated, clearly. And this is why that you hear only some females hear this, yeah, from their guy. This is what I feel as if triggers also something in a female's mind to assume that what he's doing isn't trying to hurt you. It's just simply the fact that he's just mentally fucked up in his head. But that's when they say like, oh, like, they've been heartbroken before, they've been in a situation where they've been like, you know, their girl was dishonest and... Or they will give the whole situation of like, let's say for the child situation I was saying before, like they obviously they have a child and then with them and then it's like, oh, they now all of a sudden never wanted the child when you was the one that wanted the child. And the female said she wasn't ready for the child because she had her children that she was looking after regardless by herself anyway. So, you know, if you ain't trying to marry her, put a ring on it and be civil and be loyal. Let me say that again. And be loyal, because that is one big thing. That's what I see. It's like, forget about the trust and stuff anymore, because you see, when it comes to trust, you can never ever fully trust a guy. You can never fully trust a female. I'm not trying to be sexist here. Like, you can never trust a person that you're going out with, that you're dating. And the reason why you can never fully trust them is because of the way they carry on. It's the way that your pattern is always going to be slightly different to the way they live their life. They may not have grown up at that stage when you was trying to obviously settle down and be serious with them. They probably wanted to still play about and act like a kid. They probably still wanted to go dagger, dagger, dagger. They probably still wanted to do some act like Spice or flipping, I don't know. I'm sure you was thinking of some names for me, so fill in the blanks. But that's just my opinion. Anyways, don't forget to like and subscribe, obviously. If you love your mum, then you're gonna like and subscribe. If you don't, then that's the next subject for my next video, I guess. But yeah, that's how I feel anyways. It's my opinion, isn't it? Like, this is what I'm going to start doing more of, because I really do this on my Instagram. I do this so often. This is the reason why I'm doing this now for, like, the YouTube. I'm like, let me just continue doing YouTube, because if you're doing YouTube, you could do it longer. See, on Instagram, you got a minute. If you do the IGTV, then you got probably about 8 minutes. But no one's going to be sitting down on Instagram watching an 8 minute fucking video. So I do it on YouTube. But yeah, so that's just basically how I feel. I feel like obviously a guy really needs to like be more open, because they're never really open. Half of the time when a person is, well, I can only speak for myself actually. Every single time when I've gone into a relationship, which I felt is serious, that I felt that obviously will take me somewhere, it will be a thing, it will be long term and etc. That has never been the case. And I feel like it's because I need to choose someone that is confident. Let's not get it confused with arrogance, okay? Being confident and arrogant are two different things, okay? So I feel like if you have the confidence, and your guy has the confidence, you have the confidence, you can talk to each other on a level, continue as friends, but you're in a relationship, right? But then artists, it's a thing where like, in that relationship, it will get stronger and stronger. Because as soon as you do the whole, okay, we're in a relationship, let's act like we're a couple, that's when shit starts to fuck up. Because it's then a thing where like, you're then forcing it. You having to be something that you're not because you want the other person to feel comfortable or you want to impress the other person. You're having to always impress each other, basically. You got Cardi B. She impressed a lot for Offset. Offset has always been known as his cheater. He loved gal, okay? Him love gal, okay? We know this, okay? Seem like he's all quiet and everything like that, does his little tunes and stuff. But really, truly, my guy ain't shy, yeah? He knows what he's doing. He has confidence, yeah? He's just out there. But his confidence is more arrogance, I would say. And that's the situation that I can say to myself it has been, to why, obviously, I have had issues with guys in the past. Because they feel, they always act like they're shy. And then afterwards, a couple of the months down the line, they're showing their true colours. It's like they're not shy no more, or they just completely stop talking to you. You see them out and about, like, especially like the artists. When you date an artist, someone that does music, like, you think to yourself, like, rah, like, this guy, he's got all these dancers, yeah, or shaking up their booty up on him, yeah, and he's there rapping, like, and he ain't getting shy, nah. You're telling me that there's not one chick here that he felt a bit more of a bum rubbing against his knee or his leg, and I don't mean his two legs standing up, I mean the third leg, yeah. So you used to tell me that he's gonna still be shy, or he's gonna act like he's a proper business person. You, a person that is to do something like music, like I said, you need to have confidence. You need to know what you're producing. You need to be out there. You can't be going to performances and shows with your stiff, shy self. You just can't. It's like if someone was a DJ, you're DJing, you're outgoing, you're out there. Like you know what you want. Like you're doing it for a reason. So it's what you enjoy. So what you enjoy, you have more confidence in doing, right? Common sense. So if that's the case, then how comes when you're in the relationship you want to act all shy, you want to act like you know, you want to try and get to know this girl and stuff like that, but then as soon as your back is turned, he's there going fleecing off fucking every single Michelle, Renelle, and maybe even John. But yeah, and then afterwards everyone's quick to blame the woman, like, you knew what he was like, why did you go into the relationship, why did you go out of your way to go and have baby with him if you knew he was like this, or you could have told that he was a waste man, if he was never there for his other children, then maybe he's not there for his this child, or he will never be there for this child and stuff like that. And even though you, at the back of your mind you're like, okay, they could be actually right, it's like, fuck if they're right or wrong. You're not in my situation. Only I is in my situation. So only I can deal with that. Only I will be able to see that. To then decide on what it is or what my next step is going to be. So, damn. I'm also going to do a video probably later as well. So I'll do two videos every single Wednesday and Friday and Sunday. Yeah, Wednesday, Friday, and Sunday. Maybe do a couple of vlogs on the Saturday or something, depending on how I'm feeling and the situation. Tuesday, our curfew's at 10 o'clock now, so we gotta be quick on this, you know what I mean? So, yeah. Let me show you guys my outfit as well. So right now, I'm just wearing my little top dress from Pretty Little Things. This is not sponsored, by the way. I bought this with my own money. I might even do a shopping haul from Pretty Little Things, Boohoo, and also from Amazon. Amazon do some okay clothes. So he's gonna touch it. So let me just move it. But yeah, this is the outfit. Can you guys see? But yeah, this is from Pretty Little Thing. This cost me about £15, £20. It'll be in the description box below. Let me see this as well. This is mine. I buy my own shit, as you see. Self-explanatory. I'm not gonna wear something else that someone else bought for me now. Yeah, but yeah, so basically I might do a shopping haul. Yeah, pretty little things, Boohoo and Amazon, and there was something else in my head that made me say this in the first place, but I actually can't remember now. When I remember it, I'll obviously write it down in this description box below. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Don't forget to hit the notification. So whenever I do release new videos, you will see and get an update on it. Also as well, I need to do a video in regards to like these kind of conversations, but more like one-to-one, and you will see that as time goes by. Also as well, I is going to open up a new business soon, which I'm so excited about. Hopefully this will be all sorted out by January. That is my next goal. So I probably might disappear for a bit and then come back on and let you guys know when I'm actually open and doing it. But it's gonna be so lit. Like, I don't wait a snow time, because time don't wait for no one. So why should I wait for the time if the time now wait for me? You get it? Okay, so anyways, moving forward. Yeah, I'm really liking this top as well. Boy, outside today, I was getting some good looks there. I was like, no, you're thirsty, you're not my type, you're with your baby mother, and I'll give you some change. But so that's how it's gonna be today, and I'm not even being vain. This is just this is how I live, you know what I mean? I can show you updates, guys. If you don't believe me, it's all on my Instagram. Go follow my Instagram pages here, here, and here. Yeah, cause it can be lit, I'll tell you. And then obviously I'll probably get more interaction on here, because then obviously people will be looking on there and they'll be like, wow, okay, she's really entertaining, like she's hella funny, or she's talking sense there. I really get that one. That's the point I was trying to make the other day, and such and such and such. So if that's the case, then obviously moving forward, then like, you know, you get my drift. Yeah, you get my drift. But yeah, so like I said, don't forget to like and subscribe, and also as well leave any comments down below if you think what I was saying was a bag of shit, which I doubt. I'm sure I was making sense and you guys can relate. So if you can't, then I'm not being funny, but you know when I was telling you about the arrogance and the confidence, you're not even in the middle. Yeah, so I'm loving my swag today. It's like that natural mother, you know, maternity leave kind of look. I don't even know if that is actually a look, but I just feel like this one of them was like, I just had my baby and I'm going back to work now, and it's like, I don't know. It's just so, let me just stop. But yeah. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I'm also might even do some night routines as well. Night vlogs, nighttime routines. Yeah, because if I do it, then obviously I would get back into a routine, because this boy, he's keep on changing his routine, and I keep changing it back, and he keeps on changing it to the way he wants it. And obviously, like I say, this is new to me because he's a boy. I'm not saying that I can't handle boys, because I clearly can. But, yeah. it's still a learning process. Oh yeah, that was another thing I was going to say. The situation in regards to schools and stuff. I want to say to people that you need to be very, very careful. One school must inject. I saw someone on social media. Their daughter got injected. My friend, her daughter got injected today. Yeah, without the fucking parents' permission. That's what people are doing now. We knew this was going to happen. This is why people shouldn't send their children to school. But obviously, everyone wanted to just jump on the bandwagon and go along with the situation and see, unlike me, I felt smart. So I saved up during quarantine times, got my children to go in private school and a bit of homeschooling as well. So until they get a public school, which I doubt it will happen, because by the time the children even find a school that is public, it will be time to close back the schools because COVID come back again on the second wavelength. Okay,
it's an incredible thing. The Ebola vaccine and others, these are the people that have done it, or these are the people that have been around it, and they're all competing. It's an incredible thing. All of these brilliant firms, labs, companies are competing. And I will tell you, we're very far advanced. We've already started tests and trials. So I think we're going to have a very, very good answer to that very, very soon. I always say, even without it, it goes away. But if we had the vaccine, and we will, if we had therapeutic or cure, one thing sort of blends into the other, it will be a fantastic day. And I think that's going to happen, and it's going to happen very soon.
This is like real life, like stuff actually happens in real life like this. And it's down to the man, and then everyone always goes ham on the woman, like, you knew what he was like, you knew this, you knew that. Maybe sometimes it's a thing where women are just so lonely inside, like they feel that they need someone. And if they obviously need someone, they're gonna go to the demon that they do know, because the demon that they don't know is just gonna give them a new set of grief that the demon that they did know did. Do you get it? So, and it's, or sometimes it's a situation where if you have a child with a person, you feel like you have to be in a relationship because it's what you wanted. You wanted the stable parents around the child that you are about to raise. Like, you wanted it not only to be just one-sided, you wanted to be a bit, your bit of what you want to do, like of how you wanted to raise your child, and a bit of what the woman wants to do to raise her child into the good way, or the good path, or the bad path, or whatever path it is that you chose for your child. Which I'm hoping it was the good, but yeah, everybody different, like I say. But we have same traits, like we do similar things that makes us get classed as we're the same. It's like, not being racist, but it's like when back in the day, everyone used to see one Chinese man and then they will say, do you know what? All Chinese men look the same. No. They're from the same country, maybe, but they're not the same. They have the same talents, though, by making things. I must say that, but that's never here or there. But yeah, like, just be careful, people. It's just mad to just keep repeating yourself over and over again, and then people just don't listen to you, or when shit goes wrong for them or south for them, that's when they want to come and jump me down and be like, oh, you jinxed it. No, bitch. Your life was already jinxed, okay? Don't try and blame me for your bullcrap. Yeah, when I done told you before it actually happened, so you can step out of the situation so you can see it for your damn self, but you chose to stay stuck inside of it. See, I'm the type of person that I've been in a situation which has been so, so disgusting and horrible and abusive and everything, yeah, mentally, physically, and everything else you can think of, that when I ever go into relationships now, ooh, do I give problems? Oh, yes, I do. And I don't even care, because it's like, if you classing it as a problem, I'm classing it as me just being straight up with you, or something I disagree on, or something I don't like, and now you've taken it the wrong way, clearly you are not the one for me. It's just that simple. Because the whole reason to why you're in a relationship is to find the one that's compatible with yourself. Yeah, and if you're not, then what's the point? Like, seriously. If like I don't like cheese, but then you like cheese, and then I love flipping chicken, but then you say you don't like chicken, you love fish. It ain't gonna work. It just ain't gonna work. Okay? Like, so, you know, whatever in it. Take it. Take it with a pinch of salt on it. If obviously I'm offending certain people. But it's just reality. Like, you know, if you face facts and see it for what it really is, this everything I've said to you, you will completely relate to what I'm saying to you. If not, then you're just lost. I'm so sorry for you. Like, I really feel sorry for you. Like, I pity you for real. Like, I really do. Because see me, I'm not the type to give a fuck. Or care. And I'm so sorry if I'm the keeper swearing as well. It's just, I have it sometimes. Like, people swear around me so much that I start swearing. It's like, rub it off me. Rub it onto me. Yeah. But, yeah. I just gotta say that. Don't forget to like and subscribe again, people. Like I said, I'll do more videos. I'll interact more. But obviously, I do, it's quite a lot on my Instagram. But then I'm thinking to myself, maybe I can get some Instagram videos and then put it together and then place it onto a YouTube. So it makes it like a whole full vlog or something. But yeah, I'll see how things go in it and see how I feel. But yeah. Enjoy the day, people. Like, I hope you enjoyed the day, because obviously by the time I post this will be nighttime. So yeah, and I'll do more obviously, and get better lighting as well. But I've got everything as well. I want to show you. I'll show you in another video of everything that I've sorted out, got out so far, all the goals and stuff that obviously I've written down to achieve. And I've gone halfway there. I'm pretty much like halfway there. It's just my motivation, isn't it? Like, my motivation is dedicated to other things, isn't it? So when it comes to the stuff that I actually do enjoy and like doing, I barely have time to do that because I'm too busy doing other things. Yeah. Some probably think that I probably don't even do much, but hey, that's on you, mate. that's not me, B. You believe whatever you want to believe and see whatever you want to see. What you see is completely different to what you believe. So, yeah. Yeah, that's pretty much it. That's all I wanted to say. Just thought I would just step in, you know, with that whole Cardi B situation. Because Tuesday, like, you know, everyone going to go ham on it. I thought I'll go ham on it on the YouTube rather than on Instagram. Because you see, when I go on Instagram, it's just too funny. Like, I just get so much DMs all for the whole entire time. That half of the time, I don't even want to answer back to them. Because I'm just like, I already said what I said and finish. But it can be entertaining sometimes. But I just thought, let me try to do it on a different platform and then see how it goes. But yeah, like I said, don't forget to like and subscribe. I'll probably do even makeup tutorials as well again, because my love with me, I can't, you know, I look good still in it. I know I need it. You look good in it right there. Yeah, see, it's a pretty little thing. It's a pretty little thing. Me is a pretty little thing still. That is confidence, not arrogance. Okay? All right, people. So, me, I'm going to leave, you know. Me hope you enjoy your place and time or wherever you do. And, say bye, Zai, while you mess up the place. Say bye. Zai, say bye. Bye.